Hey guys, Fallout here, and today I thought it would be a good idea to give a quick refresher guide on how to beat the Vault of Glass raid. Vault of Glass is coming to Destiny 2 on May 22nd, and I know plenty of people out there who either never played D1 or simply never beat VoG. In an interview with Polygon about the D2 version of Vault of Glass, Bungie's Joe Blackburn had the following to say. We definitely are going to make changes to make it feel challenging, like it felt before, but we don't want to go too far and to make it feel like it's a different raid. Blackburn goes on to say that the team may need to change a bit more this time around because of the leap from the original D1 to D2, but players shouldn't walk into a room and say, this is not the boss fight I remember. All right, let's move forward with the refresher guide with the following in mind. No, right now we haven't stepped foot into the D2 version of the raid yet, but yeah, the guide should be extremely close to how beating the D2 version of VoG should go. Some things will no doubt be tweaked, but things won't be wildly different. So with that in mind, let's review how to beat the original raid, Vault of Glass. But before we get going, I want to give a shout out to the sponsor of today's video, Ridge Wallets. These things are beautiful, and I'm glad to promote them on my channel because I've actually been using one myself for about the past year. No joke, this right here has been my actual wallet. A lot of guys I know are still lugging around wallets like this. Big, bulky, floppy, and uncomfortable, doesn't sit well in your pocket, and you gotta move it around when you sit down. As I mentioned, over a year of the Ridge Wallet, and I'm just never going back. It's light, sleek, and efficient. It doesn't fold or bulge out awkwardly in your pocket. It's got room for all my cards and a clip for bills when I am carrying cash. They've got over 30 colors and styles on their website, including carbon fiber and burnt titanium. Sounds like a Destiny shader. They've got 30,000 five-star reviews, one of them being mine, and each wallet comes with a lifetime warranty. Yes, you can buy just one wallet and boom, carry and use it for life. The Ridge is so confident you'll like it that they'll let you test drive it for 45 days, and if you don't, you can send it back for a full refund. Get 10% off today with free worldwide shipping and returns by going to ridge.com/falloutplays and use promo code falloutplays. Link to their site in the video description, and thank you again to Ridge for sponsoring today's video. All right, back to the raid guide. Footage courtesy of Datto, by the way. Thank you, Datto. First thing we do after dropping into the raid is open the door to the vault. I guess you could call this the opening encounter, but it shouldn't really take very long at all. You're gonna find yourself outside with a big giant door in front of you, and there will be three big vex plates on the ground. One on the far left of the area, one up top in the middle right outside the door, and one off to the far right of the area up on a cliff. Your goal is to stand on each of these plates long enough that you form a spire, which will open the door to the raid. While standing on these plates, Vex will repeatedly spawn in and try to murder you. The most tried and true method is usually to divide your fire team into three groups of two. Each group goes to take one plate, usually with one person directly on the plate and the other person roaming around killing nearby adds. When enough time has gone by of all of you standing on your plate, the door to the raid should open and you can head on in. After following the path inside a little bit, you'll ultimately find yourself at a ledge overlooking a big open area with pillars and a staircase. That is the Templar room in the next main encounter. The room itself is usually divided into three sections for the sake of making organized callouts with your team. There's the left, the middle, and the right. Your ultimate goal in the room will be to kill the Templar, the boss of the encounter, but before getting the opportunity to even fight the Templar, you have to get through several other phases of doing things, all of which take place within this room. First, you're gonna need to defend one conflux. Then, you're gonna need to defend two confluxes. Then, you're gonna need to defend three. Then you'll have to destroy all the oracles, that'll be fun. And when all of that is done, you'll have to fight the boss and kill the Templar. Okay, starting with defending the Conflux. The Conflux is a big pillar at the back of the room. Phase one is you defending just that one Conflux. Vex are gonna start popping into the room, both from the back left and the back right areas, and from the middle area at the bottom of the staircase. If too many Vex reach the Conflux and sacrifice on it, your entire fire team will wipe, and you'll have to redo that particular phase of the encounter. You're gonna notice that some yellow health bar Vex called Fanatics will leave glowing pools on the ground when they die. You should really try to not touch that at all. If you do, you're gonna be marked for negation, and if you don't do something about that, your vision will be distorted, and eventually you're gonna die. Here's how you get rid of marked for negation. All you gotta do is walk down that staircase in the middle of the room and step into the big pool on the floor, and boom, now you are cleansed Gigi, go ahead and remember that little cleansing maneuver. It'll be a recurring theme as long as you're within this room. Okay, phase two of the Templar room. Defend the left and right confluxes. Essentially the same thing as before, except now instead of defending one in the back of the room, you've got one on the far left and another on the far right. Rather than going three guardians on the left, three on the right, you should probably think about maybe two on the left, two on the right, and maybe two guardians, not all the way in the back, but occasionally roaming back to the middle-ish of the map. Reason being is that the Vex are going to continue to flood out of that bottom middle area, and you don't want to completely ignore them because eventually you would be pretty much overwhelmed. Again, if any of you get marked for negation, you now know what to do. Head down to the middle, cleanse up on that big plate, and you're good to go. Make sure that not too many Vex sacrifice themselves at each conflux, and bam, phase two over. Now we're on phase three. Defend all three confluxes. Woo! And you should be an expert by now. You've got the original conflux from the back, then you've got the one on the left, then you've got the one on the right from phase two. Same deal as before. Defend all three. Don't let the Vex sacrifice. You should divide your team into three groups of two, naturally two for each conflux that you have to defend. When enough time goes by that you've beaten phase three, now it's time for the Oracle phase. If you're a big fan of doing the same thing over and over again for a really long time, boy, are you gonna love the Oracle phase. You're still in the same room, but while you're standing around defending yourself from the Vex, oracles, aka these glowing orbs of light, are gonna pop up around the room. Every time an oracle appears, you'll know right away because again, they glow, but they also have a chime that you can hear when they pop in. There are seven potential oracle locations that we know from D1. Here's the map from Reddit user, Three Nippled Man, of course that's your name, of each oracle location. Three can appear on the left, three can appear on the right, and one can appear at the dead center of the map. From my memory, the hardest oracles to keep track of are usually the left hidden and right hidden ones because they pop up behind walls towards the backish area of the room. You should probably have one player go wide left and one player go wide right to keep an eye on those oracles that spawn in the back area. Every time an oracle pops up, you'll need to shoot it until it breaks. If you don't do that, the entire fire team will get marked and everyone will need to go get cleansed in the pool in the bottom middle. Not only that, but you're gonna need to repeat that wave of oracles all over again, so really try to not miss any oracles because this encounter, it's long enough. There are seven waves of oracles total. The first two waves will have three each, the next two waves will have five each, the next two waves will have seven, and the final wave will require you to shoot nine oracles. Again, really try your best to make sure that your entire team is locking down the entire map with every oracle location in view and shredding them when they pop up. While you're fighting, by the way, Hobgoblin Sniperinos will be popping in and making your life harder. Remember though, currently in D2, we have access to anti-barrier scout and anti-barrier auto rifle mods on our armor, which rip through Hobgoblins like nothing. I'm gonna go ahead and strongly recommend an anti-barrier weapon for the Oracle phase. All right, when you've shot what feels like an endless wave of oracles over and over and over, it's finally time for phase five, boss fight. You're gonna know it's boss fight time when a floating shield appears in the middle of the room. That shield is called a relic, and the boss fight begins when somebody picks up the relic. Whoever decides to be a relic wielder, very important job by the way, you have a few different things that you can do when holding the relic. You've got both a light attack and a heavy attack, which you can do whenever you want. It's just a shield bash, really. But by jumping and then heavy attacking, you can do kind of a ground pound move with the relic. I'm telling you this because you should absolutely be ready to fight while wielding the relic. Another important relic move is holding the grenade button. At least that's what it was in D1. That'll make you whip out a big protective bubble, which can also cleanse members of your fire team. Hugely important, more on that later. Your final attack is your super, which naturally you can only do when your super meter is full. You'll fire a big projectile attack. That move should only be done against the boss and at certain times. So you pick up the relic and the boss fight begins. The Vex are gonna try to kill you and the Templar will now be teleporting around the room, also trying to kill you. When the relic wielder has their super fully charged, they're going to use their super projectile attack on the Templar, which will de-shield the Templar and make it vulnerable to damage. Relic wielder, definitely tell your fire team, by the way, when you're about to do this so they can prepare for DPS. When the Templar's shields are broken, some guardians will randomly be trapped in a Vex bubble, by the way. You can shoot your way out, but the relic wielder can easily help by breaking these things by ground pounding. But yeah, definitely be aware of that. If you're trying to DPS the Templar with a grenade or rocket launcher, You might end up murking yourself if you're trapped in a bubble. After a little bit of DPS, the Templar will teleport around the room to a different location, indicated by a bright beam of light and a circle. If you want, you can try and stand in the circle, and you can actually prevent the Templar from teleporting by doing that, and thereby extending the duration of your DPS phase. Note that doing that, I think, will cause more Vex to spawn into the room, but I guess kind of a worthwhile trade-off. I can't really say for certain, but I'm like 99% sure right now that one of the raid challenges for the day one world's first completion will probably be kill the Templar without letting it teleport at all, but we won't really know until May 22nd. Did I mention, by the way, that while all of this is going on, oracles are going to be spawning into the room during the boss fight? Probably important to mention that. They won't be as numerous as they were in the oracle phase, but they are there. And yeah, you're gonna need to make sure you're paying attention to them in addition to fighting the Templar. Keep having the Relic Wielder de-shield the Templar when you can, do big DPS, stay alive, and boom, boss phase over, you're now done with the Templar portion of the Vog raid. There's two ways to the next encounter. You can either go through the big door that opens up after the Templar gets beaten, or you can do what most fire teams do. Head to the left area of the Templar map, jump into a random hole in the wall containing a chest that used to contain one spirit bloom, and then drop down another hole and continue heading down. Either way, you're gonna end up at the very bottom of the cave and in the next encounter, which is the Gorgon Maze. Here's the deal with that encounter. You got Gorgons, aka Vex Harpies, who are patrolling a cave on predetermined patrol routes. If any Gorgon sees you, which you really need to be within, I don't know, about 20 meters or so of the Gorgon to happen, the Gorgon will freak out. It won't directly attack you, it'll sit there freaking out, but you now only have a matter of seconds to completely murder that Gorgon. If you don't, your entire fire team will get wiped no matter how far away you run. If that sounds easy to you, hey Fallout, why don't you just kill every Gorgon? Well, you can, but each Gorgon had a tremendous amount of health in D1, and killing them wasn't really achievable until way later. Even though the Guardians are much more powerful in D2, I would wager that the Gorgons have dummy thick health bars, and your best bet is to do what we did in early D1, avoid them entirely. Here is a very detailed, possibly too detailed, map of the Gorgon Maze courtesy of Reddit user Raichuni. Take note, there are two chest locations you can briefly pause to grab if you want, one on the far left and one on the far right. But by navigating the maze, you spawn in here, and your goal is to get here. You should try to head left through the cave, but most of the time hugging the cave walls on the right side while heading left. Some teams like to jump up the big rock formation and go up high, but I think it's easier to stay low to the ground. Be patient, wait for the Gorgons to pass, head to the cave exit on the map, and you're good to go. If the route changes in D2 Vog, and I'm sure it will, I'll definitely let you know. All right, we're almost at the boss room now. You just got to get through the following jumping puzzle. And I use that phrase lightly, by the way, because the jumping puzzle is very quick and not terribly complicated. Granted, you might need to perfect your timing a little bit, but again, not complicated. Your goal is to get to the wall on the opposite side of the big cave that you're on. In front of you, there will be platforms that appear for only a few seconds and then vanish. Really, you only have to jump on about two or three before you can simply yeet your way across the gap and land down on the ledge on the far side. Then it's just a game of hug the ledge all the way to the other end of the wall, where you will find the door leading to the final room of the raid. When everyone has assembled in front of the door, it'll open, and now it's final encounter time. Your goal of the final encounter is to kill Atheon, the raid boss. Before the boss fight though, there's gonna be a few encounters that are gonna incorporate a few mechanics you've been learning throughout the raid so far. Phase 1 of the final encounter is the Gatekeeper phase. Your ultimate goal of phase 1 is to defend a conflux that will eventually appear from Vex trying to sacrifice. The layout of the boss room, fairly straightforward. You got a left side with one portal and one plate, and there is a right side also with one portal and one plate. There's a lonely little rock island in the dead center of the map that'll be very important later, but you can ignore it for now. There's also a center area further in the back with a big old staircase. During the gatekeeper phase, you're gonna find a big yellow bar hydra floating around the room. That is a gatekeeper. Go ahead and kill that gatekeeper, and now we're gonna divide the fire team up into three groups of two. Group number one, you are the gate openers. Your job is going to be to stand on a Vex plate on either the left or right side of the map in order to open the portal and keep it open. If you hop off the plate at any time or lose it to the Vex, the portal is going to shut, which can be very bad. Group two, you're going to be the relic holders. Remember the relic, aka the shield from the Templar fight? There's going to be two of them in this first encounter. Finally, group three, you are team Conflux Defense. You're going to go ahead and position yourself at the bottom of the big staircase in the middle of the room, and your goal is to frag out. All right, you've still only killed the first gatekeeper at this point. Group one and group two, aka the gate openers and team Relic Grabber, both of you head left. That's left from the perspective of when you first entered the boss room. Gate openers go ahead and stand on the left portal to open that gate, and the two relic holders can go inside together. Technically, if you'd feel more comfortable, one of the gate openers can head inside with Team Relic. You really only need one player to open the portal. Your call. Anyway, whoever is inside the left teleporter, go in and murder all of the Vex. There should be another gatekeeper, aka Big Hydra Boy, in there. Murder it and collect relic number one. While you're in there, by the way, you're likely going to get marked by the void, another status condition where it's going to get darker and darker and make it harder for you to see. Whoever grabs relic number one, be sure to use that big bubble ability you got going on to periodically cleanse your homies of that status condition. Okay, so you've killed the left portal gatekeeper. Now you should be exiting the portal area with relic number one and head back to the boss room. Now you're gonna hop on over to the other side of the map, aka the right side, and do the exact same thing. Portal people open the portal, relic grabbing team go in, kill another big boy gatekeeper Hydra, grab the second relic, cleanse up if you need to, and head back the way you came in, back to the boss room. By the way, group three, aka Team Conflux Defense, the entire time while your buddies are going in and out of portals doing their thing, you should be in the middle of the map, of the bottom of the staircase, fragging out, defending the Conflux against Minotaurs who are actively trying to sacrifice. That Conflux, by the way, ain't gonna appear until the very first relic gets touched, so be ready for action when your teammates go into the first portal to grab relic number one. Okay, now that you have both relics, everyone should come back to the boss room, and your only job now is to join up with group three, aka Team Conflux Defense, and help them murder Vex trying to sacrifice at the Conflux. Protect the Conflux, kill a lot of Vex, and phase one over. Now we're on to phase two, fight and kill Big Bad Atheon. He's a big, goofy looking Vex, and he has a crit spot right on his tummy. He's gonna come out and shoot at you, but now is not the time to shoot back. The encounter begins when three random guardians on your team are gonna get teleported into one of the portal rooms. Team that got teleported into the portal room, you gotta call out which room you're in. In D1, Mars, which looks like, you know, Mars, was the left portal and Venus was the right portal. Bungie may pull a big sneaky and swap the two to be mean, but for right now, why don't we assume that Mars equals left and Venus equals right? So go ahead and call out which portal you got teleported to, left or right, and boss room team rotate over to whatever side gets called out. Your job is to hold the Vex plate because you obviously need to open the portal where your friends have been trapped, otherwise they can't get back to the boss room. So boss room team, hold the plate, fight off the Vex, and open the portal back to the team that got teleported away. You're gonna have a free relic that pops in right away. One person needs to grab it, and you need to fight a bunch of Vex as you attempt to get out of the portal room. While fighting the Vex, everyone who got teleported away will be marked. So relic user, be sure to use your cleansing ability as needed on your homies. While fighting those Vex, new relic team, you will notice that an old friend is back out of nowhere. Oracles, like the ones from the Templar encounter. Oh, how fun. They're gonna pop up around the air in your little area you got teleported to, so definitely shoot and break them, because if you don't, the entire fire team is gonna die. When you've killed the final oracle, which should be oracle number 7, cleanse up one last time and head back through the portal to join your buddies back in the boss room. Now that everybody is back in the boss room, very quickly, everybody leap over to that lonely center rock island hanging out over the bottomless pit. Be very careful when jumping out there to not bump into another fire team member. Otherwise, one of you or both of you will fall to your death. The reason we're jumping over to that lonely rock island is because it's now DPS time and you gotta hit Atheon with everything you have. Power weapons are the usual go-to, and back in D1, Titans would drop a bubble in the back of the tiny island for people to get a damage buff. Now, we have a Warlock Well, which I think will be much easier because so many teams get effed up by dropping a big Titan bubble on the back of that tiny little island. Anywho, whoever has the relic, just stand at the front of the fire team and pop open that bubble. Your job is essentially banner shielding it up because Atheon will be fighting back throughout the entire DPS phase. When DPS phase is over, everything will get reset and you'll do it all over again. You'll know DPS phase is over when the little timer on your HUD goes all the way down to 0. Now, do it all over again. Three new guardians will be teleported randomly through one of the two portals. You gotta open it up to bring them home. You gotta bring out the relic, the exact same thing. Rinse and repeat until Big Bad Atheon is dead, and bingo, raid over, you did it. That is pretty much the entire raid in a nutshell. Bungie is very likely gonna change up a few things, but again, as Joe Blackburn mentioned, the core mechanics of the raid should not drastically change. Anything that gets modified, I'll be sure to cover in a future guide after the D2 raid drop. Please do the like thing, do the subscribe thing, and as always, a big shout out to my Patreon supporters. Appreciate you a ton. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.